I'm gonna show you how to dodge and burn, dog. Hey guys, welcome to Phlearn. My name's Aaron Nays. You can find me on Twitter at AKNayser. Today, I'm gonna show you an awesome way to dodge and burn. Now, I know you guys have probably done dodging and burning before, but we're gonna go over a couple techniques that are a little bit new, a little bit different, and they're gonna help you to get a better result more consistently. So before we get into today's episode, we just wrapped up our huge, huge contest with over $1,000 in prizes. So all the entries are going out to the judges now, and we're gonna have the winners back to you guys soon. So we'll update you on that soon, but we wanna get into this edit. So a very, very cool image. This is actually by Ben, and this is his dog, Toro. And just a very, it makes me want a bulldog, because man, this guy is just awesome. So we're gonna use dodging and burning, and before we do, I'm gonna show you guys a couple of things that you're gonna need, or maybe not need, but are gonna really help out. The first thing that I use is, I use a Wacom tablet. This is an Intuos 4 small. The Intuos 5 is out now. You guys could pick one of those up if you wanted to. They're not that expensive. We can link to them below. They really do help out in editing, especially when dodging and burning, because you can use the pressure sensitivity of your pen to dictate how much is actually gonna be dodged and burned. So I work with one of these, I really like it, and it's something that's gonna help you guys out too. All right, the next thing we need to do is we need to figure out a good way to do the dodging and burning. Now, a lot of people will use like 50% gray and soft light layers and things like that, and that's totally okay, there's nothing wrong with that. But what I prefer, and what I'm gonna show you guys today, is making two separate curves adjustment layers. So we're gonna grab an adjustment layer here, and I'm gonna go down to curves, okay, and we're just gonna click on one of these and drag it down. There we go, something like that, looks pretty good. Now, don't worry about if this isn't perfect just yet, we can always adjust that. So we're gonna drag that one down, and then we're gonna click and grab another curves adjustment layer, and we're just gonna drag this guy up. Okay, so we have our layer that's going to be dodging and our layer that's going to be burning, and we're just gonna do them separately. Well, the one thing that we want to do, let's just choose a totally normal brush. So I'm going to choose a regular brush. You know, here's something that's in Photoshop, just like supplied by Photoshop. I'm going to start off by making our layer mask black, by the way. So I'm going to hit Command I, and that's going to make our layer mask black. So let's get to these settings that you guys might have in your Photoshop. Basically, when a layer mask is black, you can paint white on it. It's going to make whatever's on that layer visible. And in this case, it's making things a little bit darker, which is basically, this is our burn layer. So if I start painting in with, you know, how this is set up, we can see the brush is relatively hard edged. We're painting at an opacity of 100 and a flow of 100. And we can see I have like almost no control over what I'm doing. I'm just kind of like painting in where it is, but it's just like, at this point, it's an on or off type of thing. And you can see like this is, I'm not being able to get very good results with this. I can paint, hit X for switch between black and white, and when I paint black on my layer mask, it's going to go away. So at this point, I'm just painting visible or not visible. Now, here's a good thing we're going to show you. I'm going to show you guys the difference between opacity and flow and how those are going to help you out. So let's just make those invisible, and we're going to set you up with a brush that's going to help you out in dodging and burning much better. So the difference between opacity and flow, let's just get a red color, something that you guys can actually see. Both opacity and flow are at 100%. So when I paint around, it just looks like this. This is, you know, on or off. There's not a whole lot in between. Now, if I bring my opacity down to something like 40, 50%, I'm gonna paint around and you're gonna be able to see through it. But as long as I don't lift up my cursor, it's just gonna be the same color over and over again, no matter where I paint. Now, if I lift up and start painting again, you can see it kind of doubles up. I can lift up and start painting again, it's gonna double up again. So where I've lifted up and painted over and over again, it's kind of doubling up, but we're still at a lower lower opacity out towards the edges. That's always going to stay at 48% opacity because that's what we chose it. Okay, let's just delete that out. Now, let's bring our opacity back up to 100% and let's bring our flow down. And bringing your flow down to about, I don't know, 10% or so, you can see basically it's gonna look like it's doing. It's a siren outside. We're in Chicago. There's a lot of murders and fires and things like that here. It's a great city. Come visit. if I bring my flow down to 10% or so, we can see off the bat, it looks a lot like bringing your opacity down. Like if I'm, you know, painting things like that. The difference is with flow, if you go over the same area over and over again, it's going to build up. It's going to build up your effect over and over and over again. And so what you're able to do is have a lot more control over what you're painting. So instead of just being on or off at this point, you can actually build that up over and over and over again. So flow is a much better way to get control. It's because you can just go over and over again. Now, if you guys don't have a pressure sensitive tablet, I would recommend keeping your flow down really low, something like even like 3%. And there we go. We can kind of see just building that up more and more and more. If you do have a pressure sensitive tablet, here's what I would recommend. Go up to window and down here to brush. So we're on this current brush. It really doesn't matter what you're on. Go to your brush shape dynamics. I would turn on the control of your size here. This is how large or how small it's gonna get based on how hard you press your pen down, and pump up your minimum diameter just a little bit. So we can see our brush stroke down there. It's gonna get smaller as you let go and larger as you press a little harder. And I would also make sure you turn this transfer on, and you want your flow jitter over here. You don't need to crank that up, but turn your flow jitter on to pen pressure. So that's the harder you press, the more ink is gonna come out. The softer you press, the less. Okay, so let's bring our flow up to maybe 20%. So if I don't press very hard, we can see not a lot happens. Let's bring it down to 10% or so. All right, so if I'm not pressing very hard, really not a whole lot happens. But the harder I press, we can see instantly I'm putting down a lot more. So we can see that's a huge difference using flow instead of just, you know, having this be at 100% and having that, you know, there's a pretty big difference. So that's the control that we're gonna need when we're dodging and burning, and do make your brush that way, and then you're gonna be able to dodge and burn much better. So let's choose that brush that we just made, and here we're gonna go. So instead of just being like on or off at this point, what we're gonna do, I'm gonna go ahead and fill that with black again. I can paint now, and I'm just gonna paint white over the areas that I want to be a little bit darker. And you can see I'm just going over and over again, and I'm not lifting my brush up. I'm just painting over and over again, back and forth. And then when it looks like it's a little bit, when it looks like it's dark enough, I just let go. I back up off of there, or I move to a different space. You don't even have to let go, actually. You can just, like, you know, move somewhere else. So as I go around, what I'm doing is I'm looking for the dark areas in the image, and I'm just going in here and making them a little bit darker. That's the whole idea with dodging and burning. You just want to take the dark areas, make them a little bit darker, take your light areas and make them a little bit lighter. There we go. So it's going to be a lot more subtle, and we're going to have a lot more control over what we're doing. And you can do quite a bit to actually like sculpt out a shape with this. So this is just burning. This is just making things a little bit darker. And I'll show you guys the before and the after with that. So you can see how this is relatively flat. I mean, it's a bulldog. It's not incredibly flat. But now we can see there's a lot more depth. Like it really does look like it's, you know, there's more depth in the folds of the fat on his face, which is so cute. And that's the whole idea with dodging and burning. You're just going to be able to add, you know, a lot more of this definition in. But it's really important that you do, you know, the first part of this tutorial, get yourself working with a brush that's actually going to allow you that control. Because if not, you're just painting in the dark. It's just gonna be like on or off, and there's really not a whole lot you can do. Now, his face has been a little bit probably dodge and burn already, which is very cool. So I'm just kind of going even more. But if this were straight out of the camera, you would see these effects come to life even more. There we go. Let's darken up the jowls of Toro over there. That's a pretty good name. If you guys have a bulldog, what's the name of your bulldog? Or even if you don't, what's the name of your dog? Toro's a pretty cool name. I like that name. I met a dog when I was traveling. His name was Oso, which was Spanish for bear. And it was like a big chow. I really like that name too. If I ever get a chow, I'm going to name him Oso and copy. All right, there we go. So let's paint all this darker under there. Okay, so we can see that's kind of like darkening things up. Now, the same is true with our dodging. We want to lighten things up as well. So I'm just going to paint white on our layer mask, and this is just going to make this layer visible. There we go. And these areas, you just want to kind of go over the highlights. So the same like we made the shadows a little bit darker, now we're going to take the highlights and we're just going to make them a little bit lighter. Okay, and here in the face area, that's probably was already done. So we're not going to see it as much. But everywhere else should stand out quite a bit more. So dodging and burning is a whole lot of fun. You can really change an image and get a much nicer effect, really make something a lot more dynamic. But now you guys know how to do it the easy and the right way, in the way that's gonna give you a lot of control over what you're actually doing in Photoshop. So let's just show you guys the before and the after. There's the before and the after of our bulldog. And if you guys wanna back these down, let's say your darks are too dark, all you have to do is click right here, double click, and then you can just control how dark or how light your dodging and your burning is. All right. I'm getting all choked up. I just love this image so much. All right, I don't know what happened there. I can't talk in Photoshop at the same time. So we can control how light or how dark these things are as well, which is why I prefer doing this to other methods, because you have a lot more control even after you paint it. So cool, guys. Well, I hope you liked this method of dodging and burning. Thanks so much for watching, and make sure you get those pen pressure things set right. If you are using a Wacom tablet, that flow set to pen pressure is gonna really, really change some things for you guys. I can't wait to see your results. Post them down below, and let me know the name of your dog. Dog. Phlearn, you guys later. Bye, everyone. Hey, guys. Welcome to Photoshop.